have to remember your why.
Yeah.
That's the way how you get the confidence, you know.
I would say just, you know, being goal oriented.
You have to have your positive
mindset.
Yeah, that's the yes.
Hello, beautiful people.
Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Welcome back to Brugge's Positive Vibes. This video is going to be a special one because we are going to talk about sport motivation. I will have two guests. I will talk to two professional basketball players.
One of them will be Anthony Matthis, an American professional basketball player who has also been playing in the NBA G League, while the other one is GORAN from Montenegro, who has been playing professional basketball from 2005.
We will see like the way they think, how motivated they are, and where they get their motivation from. And yeah, let's get started. One of them is Anthony Matthis. Here we have GORAN. Oh, he's one of the nicest person I have ever met. We met for the very first time now, so I think this conversation will be interesting. So that's why I highly appreciate it. Yeah. And yeah, thank you, Gayo, for being
guys,
here.
Thank
I appreciate
you for these
it.
Nice words from the beginning. Thank you.
I appreciate it. You have all my respect. I highly appreciate it. This year, and that he supports my YouTube channel.
Of course. Thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
Thank you very much. So, are you ready? We can start.
Yeah.
I don't know what you guys think about it, but I was always wondering, like, how professional sports people can be that highly motivated, because I think it's kind of difficult to maintain such a lifestyle. So my first question would be towards you, like, how would you describe your life, like, with three positive words, like, as a sports person?
Yeah. I would say the first one's perseverance, because you go through a lot of negatives, and not a lot of people see the hard work that you put in and day out. They just see the game days or, you know, when we win, but they don't see like the background stories. So when you lose, you go home, you're not very happy, you just want to go home and go to sleep. So the first one and the main one would probably be perseverance. The second one, I would say just, you know, time management. Really realizing how to manage your time, because obviously we play basketball so much, but also we have families we want to hang out with. We want to spend time with families. Then we also want to have fun with our teammates. We want to hang out. We want to do different things. But at the end of the day, you have to realize, you know, what's the most important: basketball and family at the end of the day. For me personally, at least.
Yeah.
And then my third one, I would probably just say determination. You know, you got to be really determined. Like I said, there's a lot of practice days, a lot of days where we're exhausted, we don't want to be in the gym, but you got to think about the end goal, which for me is to play, you know, at the highest level that I can.
Three positive words, just all my life sports with three positive words, okay.
Like the key ones.
Yeah. Like happiness, enjoyment, and success.
What do you think, which one is like the key one from this? It's a hard question.
Happiness. I think
really?
Happiness. Yeah. Happiness. I mean, that's what I mean, if you do something what make you happy, then you can do it a proper way, and like everything starts from happiness. I mean, if you are happy, then you are positive, then everything is going well, you know. There is no mistakes.
Exactly. Yeah. I totally agree with your point. How goal-oriented are you?
I mean, I would say in my early career I was super goal-oriented, and I still am. But my goals change from year to year, you know. I go on a team and sometimes the goal might be different from when I was on a different team. So my goal with this team is just, you know, obviously we want to stay in the first division. We want to finish the playoffs really well. And I just want to come in and help the team any way I can.
That's really nice.
Yeah.
That's really nice. How do you get that highly motivated every single time? Because, you know, like, you have practices like two times a day or even more. I don't know, it depends. And I was always wondering about it.
Yeah. I would say just, you know, being goal-oriented. Obviously, we have an end-of-season goal, which we want to stay in the first division. So I just try to think about it to that every day. When I wake up or sometimes in the morning, I don't have to practice. Just got to think about our end goal as a team. And it gets you pretty motivated to, you know, go out there and work hard.
Okay, I mean, this is, I can say that I'm already in basketball like 25 years, already just practicing basketball, and it's not easy to find a motivation every day, like to going to practice, you know, like in this like 25 years. But something would like push me going forward and to be like to be positive and to tomorrow to be better than I'm today, you know. And I'll do everything just to be better. When you say it like this, looks like easy, but of course it's not easy. And every day you have to push yourself to be better version than you were yesterday. So it's just
exactly.
About a positive mind. Of course, you can take it like from many things. Of course, there is on first place is like my family, of course, who support me like all my life, through all my career, through all up and downs. You can, I mean, find positive vibes and positive motivation in every person you met, for example, on the street, doesn't matter, you know. So it's just up to you. I mean, if you are set like that positive, then you can see just positive things and you act like that.
Exactly. Yeah, by the way, he has a super cute family and I really love them. They are super nice.
Thanks.
And especially his little daughter, they are really nice. Okay, let's head to the next question. If you're ready.
I'm ready.
And how do you handle these lower points in your life? When you how can you face like with some difficulties, or when you lose a game, how can you get back on track?
If you know, when it comes to basketball, I just try to, you know, put it super simply that it's just a game. It's not life or death. It's not nothing serious like that. And my family does a great job of that. You know, just reminding me that it's just a game. It's, at the end of the day, win or lose, everything's gonna be okay. Your life's gonna go on. But sometimes I take the game a little too serious. You know, I get too upset, too happy, too mad, or whatever it is on the results of the game. But at the end of the day, it's just a game.
Yes.
Yeah, of course. I mean, every job has like some up and downs or some positive, negative things. Basketball, like you said, sometimes when you lose the game, it's not easy. When I was younger, it was like kind of stressful, you know. Now that is different, you know. I'm getting older and more experience and everything, you know. It's some, for example, lost teach you how to be better next time. So I'm trying just from that loss to take like positive things, and that one who are negative to make it positive for the next game. So you just, you know, you have to stay focused and to practice more, because everything, all, for example, or confidence coming, just my opinion, just coming from the hard work, you know, and from the passion you put yourself in that what you're doing. If you're doing 100% every day, for sure you will be better, you know, and confidence will just grow or rise, like. So it's just up to you how you watch the things, and if you think positive, for sure at the end of the day it's gonna be like something good gonna happen. So we have to be positive as much as possible.
Exactly. This is the keywords I was looking for, the positivity, and surround yourself with positive people, because I think then your life like will change as well.
Yeah, of course. With the people who are like, of course, more positive and who has good vibes, you know, good energy, because I'm really run away from the people who are like negative. They're like, you know, vampires for me, you know. So I'm trying to run away from there. And if you want to be positive, you have to also to be with the positive people, to who are, you know, sharing the same. Things like you do, or same like.
Is the life of a sports person difficult?
I would definitely. It's not. We live. I mean, we play basketball for, you know, for a living, so it's awesome.
Yeah.
It's just different for different people. For myself personally, I think it's during the season. It's pretty boring, really. Like other than basketball games. Like the games are. The games are fun, and because, like, okay, and it's a single day, right? We go to morning practices for about an hour and a half.
Yeah.
I'll come home, go to sleep, wake up, go back to practice. After practice, go home, eat, do it all over again, and go to sleep. So it's like, those days are boring, you know?
So you're just sleeping between,
Maybe I'll go have something to eat, and then I'll go back to sleep, but it makes it all worth it for the game days, because the game days are really fun. Obviously, you get to go out there and play against, you know, another team with your team, and celebrate when you guys win, so that's fun. But like the practice days are not the most, you know, most fun.
I would not think that.
Yeah, but I mean, obviously, I'm in another country, so I'm getting experience with new people, new cultures, which is amazing. So
it's another life.
Yes, it is. I mean. everybody thinks when they see a sportsman, like, you know, it's easy for him, you know, look, he's playing here, you know, he's doing that here, like, but beside that, you know, like, or, you know, it's like a lot of work, a lot of sweat, you know, it's like many and many years of hard working, you know, to become something and to make some achievement in your life, you know, to make your life easier or better, let's say, you know. But they don't know what's going, you know, when they come to watch the game in the gym, you know, they see just you there playing, but they don't know what's happened like all week when you practice all week hard. Maybe sometimes you were sick, sometimes injured, maybe sometimes you didn't practice 3 days in a row because of some injury, and then you just show up yourself for the game to try to help your teammates, but nobody knows about that. When they see you there on the court, they see just, you know, you have to be like good and to play good, and they don't know like what is behind that, you know, behind there what we going through, like every day, through all practices, through all of course there is like moments when you are got nervous during the practice, during the game, and there is like a lot of, you know, contact and everything, you know, but you have to go over all that, you know, and when you show up yourself in the gym there, of course you have to be like the best version of yourself to give like everything for the success, let's say.
Exactly. Yeah, I totally agree with you. I think basically everything you want to achieve in life, it requires determination and hard work. And yeah, hard work for sure will pay off at some point. I'm also curious about it, whether you are a self-confident person?
Self-confident person? yeah, for sure. I think I'm pretty confident because in the summers, you know, I work really, really hard. You know, I'm in the gym all the time, so I think that helps with my self-confidence, but obviously I'm human, just like anybody else. After a bad game or something, I might be down on myself. My confidence might be a little low, but then I just remember how much work I put in to get to where I'm at today, so I'd definitely say I'm pretty confident, but I'm just like everybody else. There's days where I don't feel as confident, the days where I feel super confident. It just depends, really.
Yes. Yeah. Always, whatever you are doing, you always have to remember your why.
Yeah.
That's why you started it. Because
exactly.
If you know that, then you basically, you less likely.
Absolutely. Right? Absolutely. I agree 100%.
I trust a lot myself because I know myself the best, of course, and everything I did until now and everything what I'm doing or what I will do, I do it with full confidence. And trust is myself. Of course, there is like, if you want to be good in something, you have to work a lot for that, and you have to repeat the things like many times. I think everything in life, what you're doing, you have like, it's about the number of repetitions. So also, for example, in my case, actually in my job, in my case, if I want, you know, to score like some shoot or something, you know, then you have like on the practice to shoot as more as possible, you know, and to practice and to stay even after practice to shoot. Sometimes also you will not be successful, you will miss something, but there is like, you know, you trust yourself, you are positive, confidence, you know that you have confidence and it's just going. That's the way how you get confidence, you know, for the game in my case, but also in the life, for everything you do, you know, it's all about confidence, you know. When you have confidence, everything is easier, you know, you feel more comfortable in every situation, and you can find the right way how to do that, to finish the job, I mean.
Exactly. I think you can always control your mind, you can always change your mindset. So basically it only depends on you, whether you will be successful or not.
That's true. Depends. Depends of myself. Of, you know, it's individual. Also, but in my case, our sport is not individual. Like you know, there is like, for example, in my team, 12, 13, 15 players more with me. So you know, you have to be. You have to also trust to them. You know, and to have confidence in them. You know, and sometimes, of course, to push some of them. You know. to go even more, you know, to be better.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, like all confidence is coming just from yourself and from
yes.
your character, who you are, you know,
exactly.
and how you're working and how you believe in yourself and, you know, how you put yourself in that what you're doing, you know, if you give like 100% every day or you are, you know, like chill and you think everything will come over the night, it's the,
exactly.
no, for sure, nothing is coming like easy, nothing in this life,
exactly.
in the sport, in this life, nothing
yes.
is coming easy, nothing coming over the night, so for everything
yes.
we have to work like hard, really.
Exactly,
lot,
yeah, you have to have your positive
mindset.
Mindset.
Yes.
Yes. If you had to describe success,
yeah, yeah.
How would you describe it? What does success mean to you?
I mean, everybody wants to, you know, entitle success with winning games and whatnot.
Yeah.
But I think being successful for me is just, you know, seeing as many places in the world that I can, having the most fun that I can, and just enjoying my time playing basketball. Really, I think. That would be a successful career. Obviously, playing at the highest level that I can get, which is obviously the NBA. But I mean, even if I never play a game in the NBA, like I'll still have a great career. I'll still have a lot of fun. I've met a lot of people, a lot of great people. And so yeah, I think everybody's success is could be different. Mine is just, you know, having the most fun that
yeah.
I can. If I never do, like I'll
yes,
still.
Yes, I know.
Yeah.
No, but I think yeah.
Yeah.
I
appreciate that. Thank you.
And back then, even though he's not gonna reply to my message.
Yes, I will. Yes, I will.
Then I will be. No.
Always.
And do you have like a motivational speaker or
a
sports person which gives you, you know, like this everyday motivation?
Not necessarily. I mean, I watch a lot of podcasts.
Great.
On Instagram and, you know, YouTube and things like that. They're just about successful people, basketball players in specific. So I think I get some motivation from that, just, you know, understanding different people's circumstances, different people's journeys, because everybody's journey is different, you know what I mean? So
yes.
I really like watching podcasts about people's stories and how they came up. And,
yeah.
Yeah, just enjoying people's other stories, for sure.
I think if you watch these things and you are kind of getting that positive mindset, then
yeah.
you will also like more likely to go on that
mm-hmm.
path.
More than that, yeah, I agree.
And as a professional basketball player, do you have like a specific diet that you have to should follow?
Not necessarily. During the season, I don't really diet that much. I mean, I'll eat whatever, you know, we're given and. Just try to feel my body that way. But in the summers, yeah, I do follow a pretty, not strict, but, you know, I don't try to eat a lot of sugar.
Yeah.
So I try to put on more muscle in the summer, so that way through the season I feel better. So a lot of protein and carbs. So yeah, I follow, it's not like crazy strict or anything, but
mm-hmm.
I just try to stay away from things.
I think that if you eat like highly nutritious food,
yeah.
you will have also more energy.
Oh yeah, 100%.
That matters.
And drink a lot of water.
My case, I don't have like any kind of diets, you know. We practice a lot and
yes.
everything I eat, like I spend it out during the practice, you know, like two practice per day and everything. So everything, even now in my ages, you know, like everything I eat, I spend it like really there. So there is not some special program, some special diet.
Huge thank you to my special guest, Anthony Mattis, that yeah, he was here and he helped me doing this video. Thank you very much, Goyo, for your time and that you were here like to support my YouTube channel and to talk about like how determination and this positive mindset and hard work can influence your life. You could prove it that there are no impossibles as long as you have that positive mindset and you just do the hard work every single day.
Yeah, that's the truth. Thank you very much for inviting me and good luck.
Thank you. The results will come. Highly appreciate it.
Of course. Thank you for having me.
Thank you.
Bye,
guys.